According to a Yale 2019 poll, 73% of Americans now agree that global warming is occurring.
Yet, our politicians seem incapable of even taking the smallest steps towards addressing the global warming crisis.
Climate scientists want governments throughout the world to adopt policies that would limit climate change temperature increase to 1.5 degrees Celsius.
But now, there is a 95% chance that we will pass 2 degrees Celsius by the year 2100.
As a result, 37% of the world's population would experience extreme heat, being mostly unable to work outside.
Wildfires would be extensive.
Coral reefs would mostly disappear.
There would be no sea ice at the North Pole during the summer months.
And the massive ice sheets in Greenland and the Antarctic may be destabilized, resulting in further sea level rise.
Studies have shown that you don't change minds and positions with an in-your-face approach that casts the other side as ignorant or worse yet, without compassion or concern.
So Fridays for Future Seattle was inspired by Greta Thunberg and her strikes, how deeply she was motivated by the environment to stand up for something. And so we strike every Friday from 1 to 2 outside of Seattle City Hall. We are a student-led strike, but we are open to everyone. And we pull from a variety of schools in the Seattle area.
The 18th century French philosopher Denis Diderot warned his colleagues that what they wrote only reached a small segment of society. However, conversations, he said, influence everyone.
Conversations do work. Hi, I'm Rachel Belvin, a student at Seattle University and an advocate for climate justice.
And I'm Jamie Margolin, founder of the international youth climate justice movement called Zero Hour. In this film, we will speak to experts about the myths surrounding global warming and the consequences of this warming upon our lives and the planet's ecosystem, and how young people are successfully identifying and promoting solutions.
There are probably countless civilizations in the universe that have faced this problem of climate change. Did they succeed in dealing with it? It would be a pity if we did not.